गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास दैट इज क्लास 5 ऑफ द चैप्टर एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर आई ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन दैट इज क्वांटम नंबर. व्हाट इज क्वांटम नंबर? दैट इज ए सेट ऑफ नंबर व्हिच गिव्स कंप्लीट एड्रेस ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन एन एटम. Just like a person, similarly, electrons, so many electrons are present in an atom. And to identify completely, a set of 4 numbers necessary, collectively known as quantum number. That is, principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number, and spin quantum number. Principal quantum number represented by the letter small n, which gives complete idea about the shape, size, energy of the shell or orbit and distance from the nucleus also. Next, azimuthal quantum number represented by the letter small l, which gives the complete idea about the different subshell present in a cell, while magnetic quantum number represented by letter small n gives an idea about complete idea about subshell, that means orbitals, different orbitals are there, how many types of orbitals are there, how many orbitals are there in a particular subshell, how many orbitals are there in a particular cell, etc. And last one, the spin quantum number represented by the small letter s gives an idea about the spinning of an electron around its own axis. So by combining the principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number and spin quantum number, one is possesses a complete idea about the position of an electron in an atom. So today in class 6 I will try to complete 2 to 3 fundamental terms, very important one. It may be 2 marks or maybe 3 marks. If 2 mark, we write only the statement. If 3 mark means on the heading of write short notes, then we have to write in detail. 2 to 3 terms are there. The one is Aufbau principle, one is Horn's rule, and another one is Pauli's exclusion principle. So let us start one by one. The first one is known as Aufbau principle. Aufbau. Aufbau, Aufbau's principle. Mark that. This Aufbau not a name of a scientist. It is a German word, means building of. Mark that. Aufbau, a German word, means building of. Building of, filling of, building of or filling of the orbitals with electrons. How the electrons are arranged in the different orbitals of a particular subshell and cell is easily known by applying this principle. So this principle gives us an idea, clear-cut idea about the filling of the electrons, the arrangement of the electrons in various subshell, in various orbital. So according to this principle said that electrons are accommodated in the various orbitals, in the various subshell, in the increasing order of their energy. That means the subshell which one lower energy filled first, then the subshell which one larger energy, higher energy filled later. Then question arises, between the two subshell, which one is lower energy, which one is higher energy, how you know? It is calculated, it is decided in two ways. One is in diagrammatically, and one is by applying one rule, that is known as N plus L rule. Mark that. One is known as N plus L rule, where N is known as principal quantum number and L is known as azimuthal quantum number. For example, I represent 3s, 4p. Mark that. These are the two subcell. In previous class, I already give us a little idea that while writing a subcell, we use a number and a letter. Number denotes to principal quantum number. Letter denotes to azimuthal quantum number. Mark that. 3s means S subcell of third cell. 4p means P subcell of fourth cell. So if two subcells are there and one electron, suppose one electron is available and nearby two subcell is there, question arises, that electron move to which subcell or which subcell possess lower energy? Apply this N plus L rule. So find out the N plus L, principal plus azimuthal quantum number value for these two. Mark that. 3s means principal quantum number is 3. S azimuthal quantum number starts with 0, 1, 2, up to n minus 1. So for S, azimuthal quantum number is 0. So 3 plus 0 is equal to 3. Similarly, 4p, 4 is the principal quantum number, and P, S is 0, P is 1. That is 1, 4 plus 1, that is 5. Mark that. Which value is lower? This one is lower. That means 3s subcell is lower energy. So that electron enter to 3s orbital. So two different way are there. One is in diagrammatically, we discuss later, and one is N plus L rule. By this rule, we know that which one is lower energy. Rule number 1.1 is over. Condition is that if two subcell possess same energy, mark that. One is 3s, one is 2p. Mark that. 2p means principal quantum number 2, azimuthal quantum number 1, that is 3. So in this case, the rule 1 fails. Rule 1, what is rule 1? I repeat again. The subcell whose N plus L value is lower, that is lower energy, field first. But in these two cases, N plus L value is the same. So rule 2 says that if for the two subcell N plus L value remain same, then whose principal quantum number is low, that one is lower energy, field first. Though N plus L value for the both is the same, but principal quantum number is here 2. So it is lower energy. So that electron first enter to the 2p orbital. It is all about the above principle. So let us note down one by one. First one, this rule states that, note down this principle. This principle states that the electrons are filled in various orbitals. This principle states that the electrons are filled up. In the various orbital, or one can write or subcell in the increasing order of their energy. Increasing order of their energy. Mark that. This principle said that electrons are filled up in the various orbital or in various subcell in the order of their increasing order of their energy. That means according to this principle, for multi-electron atom, mark that. According to this principle, Mark that. According to this principle, for a multi-electron atom, the atom having more than one electron, then they are filled up in the increasing order of their energy. That means the subshell or the orbital having lower energy filled first. Then if electron left, that electron enter to the another orbital, another subshell having higher energy. Mark that. Note down next line. That means according to this principle, for multi-electron atoms, mark that. According to this principle, for a multi-electron atom, multi-electron atom means atom having more than one electron. According to this principle, for a multi-electron atom, electrons filled up in the increasing order of energy which is represented by a diagram. Mark that. I draw a diagram. By this diagram, one is able to identify which one is a lower energy and which one is higher energy. Mark that. I repeat again. For a multi-electron system, the atom having more than an electron, how to identify between the two orbital, how to identify between the two subshell, which one is a lower energy, which one is higher energy. Two ways is there, one by the diagram and one by the N plus L rule. First, we go through by the diagram. Mark the diagram. One, two, three, four, four, 3, 2, 1. Mark that. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 3, 2, 1. Mark that. First I write 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f, 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f, 6s, 6p, 6d, 7s, 7p, last one is 8s. We have to first arrange 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f, 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f, 6x, 6p, 6d, 7s, 7p, last one is 8s. Next, we draw the line, mark that, parallel line. Mark that, each line is a parallel one. As a result, first line cut one circle, second is one, third line cut two circle, fourth line cut two circle, fifth line cut three, next is four, last one is four. So you arrange this line making angle 65 or 70 degree in such a way that it cut first one, one, two, two, three, three, four, four. Next, give the arrow mark in each case left to right, left to right, left to right, left to right, left to right. Mark that. Next, you join the first last and the second first. Mark that how I join. mark that. Now it is left to right, that is right to left, next left to right. Mark that. So in this way, mark that. Suppose it is the track is there, these are the stoppages are there. We are moving through starting to ending. Mark that what are the stoppages are there. Suppose it is the starting one. So first is 1S. I rewrite this one, mark that 1S. Next, mark that next the path is 2S. 2S. Mark that next path is 2P. Next path is 3S. 2P. 3S. Mark that first one is 1S, less 2S, 2P, 3S. Now it is 3S. Move that. How I move? Mark that 3P, 4S. 3P, 4S. Mark that 4S. Next, next, next is 3D, 4P, 5S. 3D, 4P, 5S. In this way. One can arrange, rewrite starting to ending one. I repeat again, mark that 1S, next 2S, next 2P, 3S, next 3P, 4S, next 3D, 4P, 5S, next 4D, 5P, 6S, next 4F, 5D, 6P, 7S, next 5F, 6D, 7P, 8S. It is the way by knowing the increasing order of energy of the different subcell. So if we compare, mark that, if we compare 2S and 2P, then 2S is a lower energy field first. If we compare 2P and 3S, 2P is the lower energy and field first. So in this way, various subcells are arranged in the increasing order of energy. Mark that. That means, in other words, we can say that in the ground state of an atom, electron enter, in the ground state of an atom, electron enter to that subcell which possesses lower energy. If left, then it is moved to the higher next subcell of higher energy. Okay, mark that. You may try in a rough paper this one 2 to 3 times, then it is easy to remember the various subcell with increasing order of their energy. I hope all of you know practice makes a man perfect. So if you build up the self-interest, then it is too easy for you to remember in the form of diagram, that is increasing order of different subcell. That means as a result of which during electronic configuration it is easy to remember. During electronic configuration it is easy to remember to write the increasing order of the energy of the different subcell. Next point, mark that. The sequence, move to the second one. That means if one is unable to draw this one, then another formula is there to know, that is known as N plus L rule. No down, next line, no down. The sequence in which various subcells are filled up can be determined, no down. The sequence in which the various subcell, various subcell can be filled up by N plus L rule. Mark that. Already discussed N plus L rule. Point one, according to this rule, according to this rule, point one, the subcell which has lower N plus L value possess lower energy and will be filled fast and will be filled fast. This is the point one. The subshell which has a lower n plus l value. I repeat again, n stands for principal quantum number, l stands for azimuthal quantum number. So the subshell between the two subshell, that subshell is lower in energy whose n plus l value is lower and electron filled fast. Mark that. For example, in case of 3p and 4d subshell. Mark that. In case of 3p and 4d, 3p principal quantum number is 3, azimuthal quantum number is 1. I repeat again. The number represents principal quantum number starting from 1 to n, while the letter for s it is 0, for p it is 1, for d it is 2, for f it is 3. Because principal quantum number starting from 1 to n, while azimuthal quantum number starting from 0 to n minus 1. Mark that is equal to 4. Then another is 4d. Principal quantum number is 4. Azimuthal quantum number 0, 1, 2. That is 6. So which one is lower value? This one is lower value. That means the 3p subshell is lower in energy and filled fast. This is the point one. Move to the another example. Mark that. That means point two is if n plus l value for the two subshell remain same, then rule one fails to explain. So what is the rule two? Rule two says that before going to rule, mark that in case of 3p and 4s, 3 plus 1 that is 4, 4 plus 0 that is 4. Mark that in this case n plus l value for both the cases remain same. So rule one fails to explain this one. Next, move to the rule 2. What is rule 2? Rule 2 says that for the two subshell, if n plus l value remains same, then that subshell is lower in energy whose principal quantum number is low and electron will fill first. Mark the rule 2. Point two, that means if point one fell, then move to the point two. What is the point two? Point two, if n plus l values for the two subshell remain the same, then That subshell possesses lower in energy, whose principal quantum number, symbol is small n, value will be lower. Mark that in case of 3p, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, 4s, 4 plus 0 is equal to 4. No doubt n plus l value remains same, but principal quantum number value is lower. So an electron filled up fast in 3p because 3p subshell is lower in energy. So it is all about the first one, that means of Bau principle. So in this principle, one is able to arrange the electron in different subshell of a cell. Mark that how it is. This arrangement, before going to that one, this arrangement of the electron in various subshell, this arrangement of electron in the various orbital is known as electronic configuration. So one thing taking into the mind, that means before going to the electronic configuration, maximum number of electron that can be accommodated in S subshell is 2, in P subshell it is 6, in D subshell it is 10, and in F subshell it is 14, already covered in azimuthal quantum number by a rule, that is 4L plus 2. I repeat again, mark that, in S subshell maximum number of electron is 2, in P subshell it is 6, in D subshell it is 10, and in F subshell it is 14, according to 4L plus 2 rule. Here L known as azimuthal quantum number, values starting from 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. For S, value of L is 0, for P, value of L is 1, for D, value of L is 2, for F, the value of L is 3. So, by taking this one, one is able to now writing the electronic configuration. Let us start from hydrogen onwards. Hydrogen, atomic number 1, H, symbol 1. Since one electron is there, so first, lowest subshell is 1s, and one electron is there, we write 1s1, it is for hydrogen. Next is helium, He, symbol, number of electron is 2, so for lowest subshell is 1s and maximum electron capacity is 2, so the electronic configuration of helium is 1s2. Mark that, hydrogen, helium, next lithium, 3, so lowest subshell is 1s and maximum intake capacity is 2. Then one electron is left, move to the higher subshell of higher energy. After 1s, that is 2s. Since maximum capacity is 2, but only one electron is available, I write. So, for lithium, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s1. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, next beryllium, 4. So, highest 1s2, then 2s2. In this way, move to ahead, mark that. In this way, students, it is advised to you to note down in a fair note, first in rough note, then in a fair note, starting from 1 up to 30. In our syllabus, electronic configuration there, up to 1 hydrogen to last 30, that is zinc. Mark that, suppose a nitrogen, if we select a nitrogen atomic number 7, then we have to write the electronic configuration, lowest is 1s, then 2s, then 2p, so 1s, s maximum capacity 2, 2s maximum capacity 2, so 2 to 4 electron absorbed, next 3 electron remains same, though p subshell has highest intake capacity 6, but available 3, so we write, so in this way nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. For example, sodium, Na atomic number 11, mark that, 1s, 2s, 2p, maximum 2, maximum 2, maximum 6, so 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 6 is 10, already completed, next 1 electron left, so after 1s, then 2s, after 2s, 2p, after 2p, that is 3s, so electronic configuration of sodium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Move to calcium, try among yourself in this way. Move to calcium, that is 20, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, mark that, 2 to 4, 4, 6, 10, 10 to 12, 12, 6, 18, so after 3s, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, then 4s, 2, 20. Next, scandium, that is 21, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, again 1 electron left because maximum intake capacity of S is 2, so 1 is left, that is 3d1. Next, 22, up to this same, 3d2, 3d3, 3d4, up to 3d10. In this way, practice yourself in first rough paper, then in fair paper, 1 to 30. Another one important thing, remember that this one I write up to this one, and also in order to save time, in order to save paper, another way is also there, that means by using noble gas configuration. For example, you know noble gases are there, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. Mark that. Suppose I select oxygen. Suppose I select oxygen. Atomic number is 8. So I can write 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Mark that. Oxygen. I can write 1s2, 2s2, 2, 2, 4, then 2p4. 2, 2, 4, 4, 8. It is one type of electronic configuration. Then I use noble gas configuration. Means from the in between 1 to 8, which noble gas is there? Helium is there. So I can write helium He. Means I cover up to 2. Rest I can write 2s2, 2p4. One also write in this way. Another example is there. Magnesium 12. One can write 1s2. 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. It is a way of writing the electronic configuration. Now, in between 12, which one is there? Neon, nearest one, neon is there. That is a 10. So I write neon. Neon means 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, up to this one is cover. Then I write 3s2. Mark that it is a time saver. Neon 3s2. Similarly, I write that is calcium, mark that, calcium 20, how can I write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 2, 2, 4, 4, 6, 10, 2, 12, 6, 18, 2, 20, mark that, it is the way of writing the electronic configuration. Then I recall, between 20, which one is there? Argon is there, 18, so I can write AR 18 argon means 2 to 4, 6, 10 to 12, 6, 18 up to this one cover. Argon 18, 4s2, one can also write in this way. It is known as the noble gas electronic configuration. That means if any one atomic number, that is 40 is there, then in order to write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, a difficult task, a time lengthening one there. So recall that between 40, which one is there? Krypton 36. So write direct krypton 36, next element. It is the electronic configuration of neutral atom. Then we switch over to electronic configuration of an ion. Mark that. First one is electronic configuration. Ion means two are there. One is cation, one is anion. One is a positive ion, one is a negative ion. So let us start with a positive ion. That means Na plus, Mg2 plus, Al3 plus. Mark that. Suppose we have to select the cation. Cation means when a neutral atom loses electron, then it is known as a cation. Na plus means sodium atom loses one electron. Sodium atom, we know atomic number is 11, loses one electron. So Na plus means it possesses only 10 electron. It possesses only 10 electron. Similarly, magnesium, atomic number 12, it loses 2 plus, means 10 electron is there. Aluminium, atomic number 13, it loses 3 electron. So already it only possesses 10 electron. That means we have to write the electronic configuration for a system having 10 electron. So keep in your mind that sodium is there or magnesium is there, not necessary. Keep in your mind, I have to write the electronic configuration of a species having 10 electron. Mark that, 10 electron, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, same thing, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 1s2, 2s2 2p6. Keep in your mind, I repeat again, while writing this one, keep in your mind about the number of electron rather the atom or ion. It is all about the cation. Next, switch over about the anion. So before going to the anion, let us in another difficulty part is there. In case of after 21, that means we go through the electronic configuration cation of specially transition element. For example, that is Fe2+, that is Cu1+, Zn2+, mark that. Suppose what happened this one, there is a very very important point is there, mark that. Before writing this one, it is necessary to remember the atomic number up to 30. I hope in 10th all of you remember up to 1 to some, maximum one remember 1 to 30, but some of you remember 1 to 20. Then here you have to remember 21 to 30. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. Mark that. That is zinc is 30, copper is 29. Iron is 26. If we go through the noble gas electronic configuration, that means argon 18, 4s2, 3d6, argon 18, 4s2, so before that one, copper is some exceptional cases is there, leave out that one. So zinc, that means argon 18, 4s2, 3d10. Mark that is the electronic configuration of neutral atom, neutral iron and neutral zinc. So one thing is that it lose 2 plus means loses 2 electron. 2 plus means loses 2 electron. One important thing that atom loses electron from where? From inner cell or in between cell or from outer cell? Simple answer. That is from outer cell. Outer cell otherwise known as a valence cell. So how you know which one is the valence cell? How you know which one is the outer cell? Cell, when cell comes to the picture, focus to the number. Which one is the larger number? That one is the outer cell or valence cell. Electron loss from that one. No doubt, you never say that it is the valence cell. No doubt, it is represented in the formation of increasing energy, not for the cell. So here mark that, which one is the higher number? This one is the higher number. So it is the valence cell or outermost cell. From that cell, we have to remove the electron. It is 2 plus, means 2 electron lost. So from this 2 electron lost. So the electronic configuration of Fe2+ is argon 18, 3d6, never remove from this one. Similarly, mark that it is the electronic configuration zinc. Which one is the larger valence cell, outermost cell? That is 4. This one is there, loses 2 electron. So configuration of Zn2+ is argon 18, 3d10. Let us consider another example, manganese, that is Mn. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, 25, 2+, that is argon 18, 4s2, 3d5. Mark that. Which one is the valence cell? This one is the valence cell. We have to remove 2 electron. So the electronic configuration of manganese ion is argon 18, 3d5. This one, the electronic configuration of some cation. Next, move to the electronic configuration of anion. What do you mean by anion? Anion means a neutral atom gains electron. O2 minus means oxygen gains 2 electron. N3 minus means nitrogen gain 3 electron. F minus means fluorine gain 1 electron. Mark that. N3 minus, nitrogen atomic number 7, oxygen O2 minus, fluorine F minus, mark that. That means total number of electron is 7 plus 3, that is 10. It is 8 plus 2, that is 10. That is 9 plus 1, that is 10. These are known as isoelectronic species. So now, never keep in your mind that I have to going through the electronic configuration of nitrogen or oxygen or fluorine. Keep in your mind that I have to go through the electronic configuration of a species having 10 electron. How it is possible? Mark that. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So it is the little idea about the electronic configuration of some neutral atom and cation and anion. Next, switch over to some special cases. That means where this normal rule is not applicable. As we are discuss about 1 to 30, two cases arises. One is known as chromium and one is known as copper. Remember that, very, very important. Always in question, exam paper question is there. That is, write down the electronic configuration of copper and chromium. Mark that. Chromium 24, copper 29. If we apply that same normal concept of electronic configuration, then it becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d4, 1, 2, 2, 4, 6, 10, 12, 18, 20, 24, or by noble gas configuration, that is argon 18, 4s2, 3d4. Similarly, the case of copper, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d9. Or by noble gas configuration, argon 18, 4s2, 3d9. Mark that. If we go through normal electronic configuration, but it is not correct. Some deviation is there. Some disturbance is there. What is that deviation? That means always the electronic configuration based upon the stability. It has been observed that during electronic configuration, the orbital having half filled or exactly full filled orbital are found to be most stable. I repeat again. Orbital having exactly half filled or exactly full filled orbital are found to be most stable. So mark that one by one. First we discuss first one. In case of chromium, mark that. Last one is 3D. 3D, third D subshell. We know third D subshell possesses 5 orbital is there. If we go through this one, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 d orbitals are there, that is dxy, dyz, dzx, ds square minus y square, and dz square. That means 4 are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. That means in order to attain the maximum stability, one electron jump from here, as a result of which the actual or the correct electronic configuration is argon 18, 4s1, 3d5. As a result of which 4s, one electron is there, exactly half filled, and d orbital is there, each one, d subshell is there, each orbital is exactly half filled. That is, it is found to be more stable. So this two deviation, that means half filled or full filled in case of copper and chromium, we will discuss later. Next, we should switch over to another one principle, very, very important one, that is known as Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Next one, Hund's rule of maximum मल्टीप्लीसिटी. सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस दिस वन, देन वी नो डाउन द प्रिंसिपल. व्हाट इज दिस रूल? दिस रूल स्टेट दैट व्हाइल राइटिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन, while filling the electron in various subshell, while filling the electron in various orbital, one thing taken into account that they are arranged in increasing order, and for each subshell, the subshell which possesses more than one orbital having same energy, these are known as degenerate orbital. I repeat again, the subshell, S subshell contain one orbital, P subshell contain 3 orbital, D subshell contain 5 orbital, and F subshell possess 7 orbital. So one subshell possess more than one orbital and having equal energy, these are known as degenerate orbital. So while filling up the electron in that degenerate orbital, one thing taken into account that electron filled up in various orbital singly, then if electron left, then only pairing takes place. In other word, electron while entering into the various orbital in the increasing order always try to maintain in such a way that maximum number of unpaired electron remain there. For example, mark that nitrogen, that is N atomic number 7, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. If we represent this one in orbital mode, that is in box-like diagram, mark that, box-like diagram, S subshell possesses one orbital, it is known as S orbital, second S, it is also 1s2, 2s2, then P subshell possesses 3 orbital, known as Px, known as Py, known as Pz. So first in S, first electron filled singly, with pointing upward, that is clockwise direction, spinning quarter number plus up. Next one is anti-clockwise, spinning quarter number, that is minus up. So filled up, then simply filled up, 2 to 4 electron over, next 3 electron is there. 3 orbital are there, 3 electron is there. So this rule says that electron filled up singly, 1, 1, 1. If fourth electron is there, then pairing starts from this one. That means we have to arrange electron in such a way that always try to maintain maximum unpaired electron. That means electron pairing in case of S orbital, electron pair at second electron. In case of P, electron pair the fourth electron. In case of D, electron pairing starts at the sixth electron. And in case of F, electron pairing starts at 8 electron. Okay, now write down this rule, that is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Mark that, this rule state that electron pairing cannot take place in the orbital, this principle states that electron pairing, electron pairing cannot takes place in orbital. Electron takes place, this principle said that electron pairing cannot takes place in orbital of the same subshell, in the orbitals of same subshell having same energy. Electron pairing cannot take place in orbital of the same subshell having same energy till vacant orbitals are available to them. Vacant orbitals are available to them. That means if vacant orbitals are there, pairing does not take place. You paired singly till all orbital are filled up, then pairing of electron takes place. That means in another way, this principle said that electrons are distributed among the orbitals in a subshell. That means, note down. That means, in other words, this principle may be represented as electrons are arranged in various subshell. Electrons are distributed, electrons are arranged in the various subshell in such a way to give maximum number of, in such a way to give maximum number of unpaired electrons. Mark that. In other words, this principle also says that we have to arrange the electron in various orbital of the various subshell in such a way that there is the maximum number of unpaired electrons are available. It indicates that if we go through the filling of the electron, then pairing of second electron takes place in case of S subshell, fourth electron takes place in case of P subshell, that is sixth electron takes place in case of D subshell, and eighth electron takes place in case of F subshell. So let us discuss, give him an example, how this pairing takes place. We select three examples. One is for nitrogen, atomic number 7, oxygen, atomic number 8, fluorine, atomic number 9. Mark that. Nitrogen. Next, oxygen. Next, fluorine. Atomic number 7 means 7 electrons are there. That is normal 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. If we go through the box-like diagram, mark that, it is known as box-like diagram or orbital diagram. That is, in this way, next oxygen, it is, oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, it is 2, 4 electron is there, first single, then pairing takes place. In case of fluorine, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, mark the box diagram. It is known as the orbital diagram or box diagram. Two opposite spin. 5 electron are there. 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 5. Then if you select a neon, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. The box diagram or orbital diagram, mark that. It is 2 opposite spin. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6. Mark the electronic configuration of these 3 or 4 examples. In these cases, we observe that. What we observe? Mark that. In some cases, all the electrons are paired up. In some cases, unpaired electron is minimum. In some cases, unpaired electron is maximum. Remember that the species where all electrons are paired up, they are known as a diamagnetic. Mark that. Note down, the important thing is that during electronic configuration, if all electrons are paired off, during electronic configuration, if all electrons are paired off, then that type of species is known as डायमैग्नेटिक, डायमैग्नेटिक दैट इज नॉट अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स मैग्नेट, समवॉट रिपेल टुवर्ड्स मैग्नेट. ऑन द अदर हैंड इफ वन और मोर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, इफ वन और मोर अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर अवेलेबल देन दैट टाइप ऑफ स्पेसीज आर नोन एज पारामैग्नेटिक, पारामैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस मीन्स अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स मैग्नेट. सो क्वेश्चन इज दैट प्रेडिक्ट द मैग्नेटिक नेचर. सो ड्रॉ द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन बॉक्स लाइक डायग्राम, देन वन इज एबल टू नो वेदर अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन इज देयर और नॉट. इफ ऑल इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर पेयर्ड अप देन दे आर नोन एज डायमैग्नेटिक, इफ वन और मोर देन वन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर देन दे आर नोन एज पारामैग्नेटिक इन नेचर. नेक्स्ट वी स्विच ओवर टू सम एक्सेप्शनल बिहेवियर ऑफ अबव प्रिंसिपल. मार्क दैट, दैट इज नोन एज एक्सेप्शनल बिहेवियर. एक्सेप्शनल कैरेक्टर और बिहेवियर ऑफ अफबाव प्रिंसिपल. ऑलरेडी गिव लिटिल हिंट, टू केसेस इज देयर, वन इज क्रोमियम, वन इज कॉपर. क्रोमियम 24, दैट इज आर्गन 18, 4s2 3d4, कॉपर 29, आर्गन 18, 4s2 3d9. मार्क दैट इन दिस केस सम एक्सेप्शन, सम डेविएशन इज देयर. दैट मीन्स इट हैज बीन ऑब्जर्व दैट द सबसेल, द ऑर्बिटल्स एग्जैक्टली हाफ फिल्ड और एग्जैक्टली फुलफिल्ड आर फाउंड टू बी एक्स्ट्रा स्टेबिलिटी. मार्क दैट, दैट्स वाई सम वन इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ द एस सबसेल जम्प 4s सबसेल जम्प टू 3d सबसेल एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ विच टू अटेन द एक्स्ट्रा स्टेबिलिटी. हियर ऑल्सो वन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम 4s जम्प टू 3d1. सो मार्क दैट द करेक्ट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन इज देयर, दैट इज आर्गन 18, 4s1, 3d5. हियर ऑल्सो करेक्ट वन इज, दैट इज आर्गन 18, 4s1, 3d10. लेट अस वेरीफाई हाउ दिस बॉक्स डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंट द एग्जैक्टली हाफ फिल्ड और एग्जैक्टली फुलफिल्ड. सो इन केस ऑफ क्रोमियम, मार्क दैट फोर्थ एस मीन्स वन ऑर्बिटल, डी ऑर्बिटल मीन्स फाइव, इट इज 4s, इट इज 3d xy, 3d yz, 3d zx, 3d ss² - y² and dz². So one electron is there, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So mark that exactly half filled. So exactly half filled or exactly full filled are found to be extra stability. So mark that, that is in case of, it is a chromium. Next we switch over to in case of copper. Mark that. That is copper 29, previous electronic configuration argon 18, 4s2, 3d9, but by jumping actual or correct electronic configuration is argon 18, 4s1, 3d10. Mark that s subshell is 1 orbital, d subshell is 5 orbital, that is it is 4s, it is dxy, dyz, dzx, dss² - y² and dz². Here is 1, here is 10 is there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mark that. It is, the last one is exactly fulfilled. So I repeat again, exactly half-filled and exactly fulfilled are found to be most stable. So two deviation is there. We observe from 1 to 30. One is known as chromium and one is known as copper. The extra stability of half-filled and full-filled orbitals is due to, note down, very, very important one. The extra stability of half-filled and full-filled electronic configuration. The extra stability of half-filled and full-filled orbital electronic configuration is due to the exactly half-filled or full-filled orbital electronic configuration possess extra stability is due to their symmetrical arrangement and large exchange energy due to their symmetrical arrangement, and most important is there, and large exchange energy. I repeat again, this deviation is observed by the two points generally, that is due to symmetrical arrangement and large exchange of energy. Between these two regions, some deviation is there, that is in case of copper and chromium. That is, half-filled and full-filled orbitals are found to be most stable.